Shaving. Hope you're all well. Welcome to my Saturday shave. It's a Saturday afternoon. I see we're expecting some rain this afternoon. And hope you're having a good weekend so far. I have a new soap that's been sent to me for testing. I'll introduce it shortly. It is a very exciting collaboration between Master Soap Creations and Pasteur Pharmacy in New York. It is called Bloom. This is what it looks like. It is fantastic. It is a homage to TOM FORD Black Orchid. This is what the pour looks like. I've used it once. As I said, it's a homage to TOM FORD Black Orchid. Top notes, in terms of the scent profile, top notes are truffle, gardenia, black currant, ylang-ylang, jasmine, bergamot, mandarin orange, and Amalfi lemon. Middle notes are orchid, spices, and lotus flower. And base notes are Mexican chocolate. I don't know what Mexican chocolate is. Patchouli, vanilla, amber, sandalwood, vetiver, and white musk. It's a very complex scent, but what I like about it is, as with all TOM FORD scents, it's very unique, it's very subtle, and I could use this every day. So, without further ado, let's get cracking with lathering. I'll just wet my face. The brush I'll be using today is this baby. It is a Omo 28mm super high density badger. It has a pine cone embedded in resin. The handle, see, it has this lovely metallic effect. It's a very nice brush. I don't use it often enough because it's very dense and it takes very long to dry. As you may be aware, I live in a very humid city, and dense knots take very long to dry here. Let's get lathering. Let's first do pre-shave. I'll wet the puck. I'll rub my fingers on it. We'll do the people's pre-shave. The scent is amazing. I'm going to add a bit more water. Just rinse my hands. And my nose. Let's get lathering. The soap lathers very easily. Fernando's soaps just keep getting better and better. Look at that. My favorite part of shaving is the lathering part. It's something I really enjoy. And I think most wet shavers, well, that's the differentiator, right? Between a wet shaver and a conventional canned core shaver. Okay, let's get this proto lather on my face. I just need a bit more water. I think that's good enough for me. Let's do some cleanup. I have about 24 hours of maybe 30 hours of beard to shave off, and today I'll be using one of my razors which I don't use very often. It is this. It is a vintage Ino Tosuke Kamisori. It is made of English steel. It is an asymmetrical grind. It takes a killer edge. If you can see the bevel over there, super shiny. This was honed by Dapper Shaves and a natural stone progression. And this is a silent whisker assassin.
Spray bottle out.
I think we'll give it a spritz of water. Right, here goes. This raise is extremely efficient. It takes no prisoners. It has a, it's a no fuss razor. I can immerse it in water. Obviously, afterwards I dry it. But you need to respect the heel and toe of this razor. They are very unforgiving. Sometimes it reminded me very quickly on occasion that I'm being overconfident, and it humbles you very quickly. Okay, let's do the other side. It's an extremely stiff edge. It has zero flex. But the fact that it's very stiff is what I enjoy. And as you can tell, I use both sides. It has a beveled side and a concave side. I use both sides. Doesn't make a difference to me. Okay, let's rinse and do a second pass. I think I need a bit more soap on here. Let's add a bit more soap. Fernando, the soap is very slick. Performs very well. The scent is lovely. I knew from the outset it would be a great soap. And that's why I use my camisori, because it is unforgiving. Okay. Pour some water in. I think I'll use my spray bottle. More water! Look at that creaminess. Those of you who haven't tried Master Soul Creations, give it a try. You won't be disappointed. Okay. That's more like it. Okay. Let's do a second pass. We have a friend over here. Gizmo, my accomplice. Say hi to everybody. Okay, bye. He comes to drink water from my shower whenever I have a shower. This has been a very special week for us, for our family. My wife has been awarded her doctorate in education psychology. I'm extremely proud of her. And it's a big moment for her. It's a culmination of many years, of 2 years of effort and lots of sacrifice. So I'm extremely proud of her. And this race is extremely efficient. Okay. Just let's do the challenging bits. Sorry, I'm this quiet today. This razor demands some concentration. Or else, there will be blood. It likes the blood. Let's do the fool's pass. As I said, let's do fool's pass. Fool's pass is a real treat with this razor. It's super sharp and keen and smooth. As I said, it's a silent whisker assassin. You don't hear it, it just does what it needs to do. Okay, let's just feel for touch-ups and then we'll wrap this shave up. Look, man, no soap. You can only try this with a soap that has good residual slickness. I know this is testament to the quality of your product. Well done. Some of you may wonder, it may seem as if this isn't very close here. I have a very coarse beard, so it shines through from underneath my skin. For the post shave, it has a matching splash. It contains primarily witch hazel, rose water, glycerin, and essential oils. It also acts as a toner and anti-inflammatory, and it smells great. This is definitely going to be one of my favorite scents, and I'd like to thank each of you for watching. If you've made it this far, have a great weekend ahead. Ciao. Namaste.